what's going on? Got another radar on deck. Not too shabby. And keeping with our last one was some relevant newer stuff, we're getting even more relevant. These two that we're talking about today, running the game right now. A lot of people talking.
Yeah, one came out in spring. One just came out in the summer. So
absolutely,
we're actually watching new anime.
One of these is actually going as we speak. They're not both done, which is actually pretty impressive.
It's been a while since we watched a show like that.
I can't hear those words without thinking of that song. So both of these actually started as Korean webcomics. So these are pretty big. We've heard of them, and there has been videos done to extremes on this stuff. It is a game changer. This shows that if you put in some hard work, put out some content online, it can eventually be picked up and turned into an anime. That's huge.
No longer does it have to be major companies and brands putting out anime. You can do your own thing. You can be your own thing.
It motivated me, and then I realized I absolutely couldn't do it. But, like, I felt it. And that's something else with these shows. Very motivational. Not in a way, I mean, I can't really go out and start fighting. Anywho, the two titles today, we're going to have Tower of God along with The God of High School. Yeah, you heard it right. Two God shows. Kind of. Anyways, Tower of God started June 30th, 2010 on the old Webtoon site, which is really cool because then in 2014 for both of these, they were available in English. So you loving the show and you want a little bit more? Well, guess what? You can just go on Webtoons, find them, and start crushing through it. And you're going to get more information. We kind of dabbled for a second, but we're really, really hot off the presses on The God of High School. We just literally watched all five of the available episodes right now. And something interesting, too, they also have like a making of documentary. Danielle wanted nothing to do with that.
Because I wanted more hype.
But I'm going to end up watching it. That's super cool because Crunchyroll, these are both available on Crunchyroll and they're Crunchyroll originals. So I don't think you're going to be able to find them anywhere as of yet, except for Crunchyroll. So do your free trial and use promo code. Just kidding. We don't have a promo code.
Tower of God. Oh. You can get a free trial if you don't have Crunchyroll.
Wow.
You can get a free trial. Check it out. And what? It's only $7.
It's only $7 a month.
Don't go to McDonald's one time a week and you're fine.
One drink at Starbucks
will handle
2 months of this puppy.
Yeah.
That's pretty nice. So we're going to start with Tower of God because that one, it's an actual completed 13-episode daily. And then we can talk about The God of High School because that is, as we said, it's only 5 episodes deep. We're invested. Danielle's pits were so wet in watching this show.
Oh, yeah. Svetson over here.
It's an intense
hype.
One.
Oh, my gosh.
But, yeah, why don't you tell us a little bit about Tower of God?
So, I told Tom, watching this show, they push you in there in the deep end. They don't set you up with any knowledge, which is great, because then you're learning the rules of this world the same time as the main character,
yeah,
who is Bam. So
yeah, they really just throw you into it.
They really do. So I remember we watched one episode, took a little break to make some pizza, and then I had mentioned to Tom, I want to know what the difference is between a regular and an irregular. Started episode 2, and what do you know? They were explaining it for me. So
literally the moment after you asked, I unpaused it, and they were explaining it. So that was perfect.
Yeah. So you basically have Bam. Irk. Let me go back.
That's a skirt, not an irk.
Skirt. So supposedly in this world, there's a tower. You can climb this tower. I'm giving you really layman's terms because it's very confusing. You climb this tower and you get a wish.
Yeah.
Whatever
you
want.
If you reach the top. Challenges, all that stuff.
Yeah.
You're going so layman's, I don't even know if they're going to pick up any details.
So you're greeted on screen with our man, Bam.
Yeah.
And
they say it weird. Well, that and Rachel. Well,
yeah.
Anyways.
So Bam, he's got long hair. He's just in this cave area. And you see him with this girl who we find out is Rachel.
Mm-hmm.
He's only known this life. He doesn't have any memories of who he was before. Nothing. He learns everything through Rachel. And she's telling him that she wants to climb the tower to see the stars.
Mm-hmm.
She ends. It's very abrupt.
Oh, yeah.
She ends up falling to, or she tells him she's going to the tower and she's starting, you see this light and she's starting to dissolve. And Bam is, as he would be, because this is all he's known, he's like terrified. He's like, no, don't leave me, you know, stay with me. And she ends up leaving and then he's alone.
Yeah. And then, well, no, it doesn't take long. He's alone for all of 3 seconds because she starts kind of evaporating underneath. And then he's teleported, I think, almost instantly in the show. It didn't.
Yeah,
I don't
it
think
was.
He was alone for all of 2 weeks. So what ends up being is he there with this tower thing. There's regulars or people that the tower chooses to start going through the challenges. Well, he's technically an irregular because this want and this need to follow her. He basically brought him. He kicked in the doors of this tower. He said, what up? And yeah, so then you're just following him as he's going through these challenges. He's clearly not equipped for it within the first. Well, the first challenge, he kind of crushes. He has no fear. Nothing but Rachel. That's it.
Yeah.
The show is the premise of you're just going to watch him take on these challenges. They're witty. The animation's great. The intro music is great.
And our squad is the best. You have your basic, you know, hero character, very innocent and trusting and sweet, which is Bam. And I don't know all the other character, other guy, or Kun, I think.
Yeah.
He's basically like Killua. He's a badass. And then don't really know all the powers he holds. He looks like he has a great backstory. You get bits of it in the first few episodes we watched. And then you got this huge alligator lizard guy called Rack.
Rack. He is the perfect comic relief. It's good. They're putting together this little squad. You already love them all. There's moments of, and this is that textbook dumb gator that he calls them turtles. I still don't get that. Maybe they'll eventually talk about that, but it's funny. It's got good humor. It's serious when it needs to be. The equation for anime is like sorted out. I think people know it now. So all you need is that cool story and you're good to go. So I think that's as much as I really want to divulge. Cool fighting. There's these weird swords in it.
And it's really cool seeing everyone's different powers. You get to see the administrators who host the tests to get you to climb the tower. And they're all just so cool. The tests they did in the beginning were really interesting because some of them are psychological. Some of them are based on your skill. And
yeah, you can't just go willy-nilly. And there's already these little, with both of these shows, they're very similar in a lot of these ways of the character. There's clearly something, yes, they're very good, they're very innocent, but there's something underlying that makes them incredible. I mean, we're not going to spoil anything, but in Tower of God here, someone's called the main character a monster at one point, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, I don't really know what that means, but
we're just waiting for him to pop off.
Absolutely. I truly, both of these shows are very good.
And it's a beautiful show. I did write my notes that we made mention watching last night that the soundtrack is killer.
Soundtrack's great, especially for both. But during Tower of God, even in the middle of the episodes, just the background music is great.
Yeah, we got a beautiful, I'm always interested to see shows' intro sequence.
Mm-hmm.
If they put effort behind it or how the style is, and the style is beautiful.
Well, they got Sneaky, too, not on this one, but God of High School, which we'll talk about that intro separately. But both these intros, we like both of them. That's all, you're going to keep hearing these large exhales because, we enjoy. Final things on Tower of God, though, I'm trying to think here. I would say that it being done, this is probably the one to start with between the two, unless you like to week by week watch and keep caught up. This one's already done, ready to watch. Just go on Crunchyroll and you're good to go. And we've shown you can get this done in a couple nights.
Yeah. They're how many did we episodes. Watch yesterday? Six, maybe?
Probably
we
about six.
About halfway through. So you can probably crush these in 2 days if you wanted to.
If you want a no life like us. Well, it's not no life. We still went to our jobs. We still did all that. But nevertheless, it's a recommended. Hence why it's on the radar.
Yeah.
So I guess, we want to go right into God of High School here.
Yeah. Holy
mother of mercy. This one's still fresh. We're still going to get things wrong, but this one's still fresh.
All I want to say first is is it bad that I need a break from all this hype? Like, no. my stomach hurts.
My skin is actually sore from getting goosebumps on and off. This one, we knew going in, it is basically tournament arc the show. And that's what I was fine with that. But I was also kind of nervous. I'm like, okay, well, it's just each episode's fights, which I'm down with. But no, the show's also got some in-depth complexity with your characters, all that. This character, no amnesia. That's a good start. But this character is like that Goku figure where he's just innocent. You know, the Goku, the gone. It works.
Trying to get it's stronger. It's
proven to work because then you know... When you put someone on that end of the personality spectrum, you know that when they do take it serious, you feel it harder because you're like, wait, he's mad? That guy's never mad. It's a cheap trick, but...
We love it.
I eat it like cake, baby. So this show is kind of right in the title. So this is high school students are actually competing, and right now, where the show is currently at, it's just the regional level, but there's these fighting tournaments to find the strongest high school student, and if you make it to the end, you get a wish. Both of these, make it to the end, get wish, boom. Very similar, but very different. Very different. The animation for both of these, the art styles are dramatically different, but what I will say is, the art for both of these, breath of fresh air. You can tell technology is getting so good with these shows. They're just using some really cool techniques, and especially in God of High School, the fighting sequence are jam-packed. It's not waiting a beat. And then on top of that, you've got all these weird perspective shifts. Sometimes you're getting your ass kicked, and sometimes you're kicking ass as the viewer. I like it. Do you like it?
Oh, yeah, I'm into it.
Hyped. This one, so we're following Mori Jin, a Taekwondo specialist. There's something special about him. We find out it right in the beginning. It's something about his grandfather. It's something special. But he gets these two compatriots throughout the show. Friendship. We're into it. And it's a very nice thing. We just watched the latest episode, episode 5, currently. So what a sentimental, sweet... Oh, man.
Yeah. It's good. It was because we wanted to stop a couple episodes earlier so we could record this episode and do some other stuff for the podcast. And we kept saying, oh, we can't end on that cliffhanger. We can't end on that note. And then this last one, it finally finished out to where I'm A-OK Perfect. That I have to wait a week for the next episode.
Exactly. Because regionals are done. I'm not going to tell you who won. Watch the dang show. Yes, it's Fighting Simulator 2020, but there is some substance there. So if any of your friends are telling you, oh, it's just a tournament arc. Who doesn't love tournament arcs? We did a dang episode on tournament arcs, for heaven's sake.
Well, and this is the best type of tournament arc because you're not getting filler. It's constant story.
Yeah.
And they go in between. I think the fights are just long enough to where you can see really great choreography and the visuals. And then you're also getting the backstories.
Yeah.
Which is great. You're getting the meat and potatoes, and then you're getting the eye candy.
Dinner and dessert. Not too shabby. Exactly. This is where I will say you can tell that, at least for me, the fighting came first, and that's, of course, when you're writing something cool, that's going to... There are some weird story points that happen that it switches from one scene, and then suddenly there was almost this... It's not really a spoiler, but this backstory, like this... You can tell the enemy is like this weird cult going on behind the scenes. Mm. And I was like, oh, well, that's just... Okay, all right, sure, why not?
Yeah, I'm wondering to see how that comes into play. There's been a couple shows we've watched where there's this weird side cult, and it's like, we're doing this again. They had a little bit in Villainous.
A little bit.
And
it's always this Dark Legion thing, which, yes, that's fine. I'm fine with a little Dark Legion, but don't just, come on, do something. Like, I feel like Fire Force switched it up. Well, maybe not really. Maybe that's a little bit of hypocrisy there. It is cool that his brother has taken it in. There's this weird little thing, like his brother's on the other side. Mm-hmm. Blah, 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 blah. Fire Force spoiler, but it's not really a spoiler. Well, no, it is. It is, and I apologize for that. Erase that from your memory. But yes, that's pretty much it. We can't really divulge too much because, no, at the core of this show, it is just a fighting show, but man, there are a lot of cool fighting techniques in it, and the animators, beautiful. We saw, and going back to the technology portion of it, we did see in the making of, these animators are using this motion capture data, and that's why they're able to animate these so beautifully. And they're all talking about, like, each character, oh, they're a master of this style of fighting. So it's cool. You get to see a mix of these weird fighting styles fighting one another.
Mm-hmm.
And they do that effect that happens in anime that I am all about it. It can happen 1,000 times and I'm fine with it. It is this hitting connect and then like a still couple of frames, like it's just boom. And then this jet stream almost comes out of the character being hit on the opposite side. They did it in Fire Force. They've done it in a bunch of fighting anime going way back even. But that effect is so cool. And yes, I keep saying Fire Force. When my mind is on like a couple shows, that's it. That's all I'm going to be able to reference. It's like when I kept saying Game of Thrones on our first couple episodes.
Oh, yeah.
Ay, ay, ay.
Something I want to talk about.
Let's talk about
for
it.
Any of the ladies that might be listening.
Mm, okay.
My biggest gripe is, what is my biggest gripe? Whether it come to drawings, the games you put on your phone or anime, what is it?
Don't you talk about my game. there's gameplay that I like. There are also some scantily clad. You hate the scantily and all the women being very overly sexualized, which I agree with.
Yeah, which, listen, I'm fine. I like enjoying it once in a while. Okay, I can appreciate when something has drawn sexy and looking fine, okay?
Fine.
It doesn't have to be men. I can look at if they've done a female good, that works for you.
Exactly.
I don't need to see it for every dang female.
Or give it a purpose, right? Valentine from Cowboy Bebop. There is a reason that she's so, you know, scantily clad. It's because she uses it as her character and all that stuff. We've talked on that.
Exactly.
But I totally agree.
So what I love from a couple of the shows we've watched recently, like Alice from Altization.
Oh, so cool.
She's bae with actual clothes on. You know,
sickest armor around.
The sickest
she's
armor.
Cool.
She's awesome. And then you have Tower of God and God of High School, where you have, like Alice from Altization, Sword Art Online, Altization. If you haven't watched it, go back, watch all of SAO. I'm going to say it in every episode.
That's a lot longer of a... We're asking you 2 13 episode shows right now. She wants you to go watch...
I don't even know.
A lot. That's a lot.
So basically, I'm enjoying that we're getting these female leads...
Mm-hmm.
You from God of High School, and you have, I don't know what her name was, but you have Lizard Girl from God of the Tower of God, and then that other one.
She was so cool, the Lizard Girl.
You have these powerful women that part of their character is not having their tits out.
Which is great, and I think anime has always had a problem with that, clearly. It's definitely a trope. It's getting a lot better now for sure, but I do still think it's almost something that each studio is like, well, throw in that character. We were talking with our friend about, are you kidding me? I'm going to bring up Fire Force again. Guys, someone stop me. But from Fire Force, we have Tamaki. Yes, she's a cool character when she needs to be, but for some reason, she's in a bikini top, and then during all these different fights, her clothes are just disappearing.
Or people touch her boobs and body.
And perhaps it was funny the first couple times. Like, I don't know, they used it in some humorous ways. But then when it's happening consistently, it almost gets to the point where you're like, okay,
I
enough.
Get it. You've hit the punchline.
We get it. The punchline, we don't need this 2 times an episode. And I think that is actually a complaint with that show with several people. And I can totally be on board with that. Just let her... So like, come on.
I'm fine if she has the bikini top. I don't see why she needs it, but don't have Shinra's hand accidentally slide under the... We don't need that, okay?
And how the hell... Anime, listen, there's a suspension of disbelief, but that one's... How does that happen? Absolutely not. No way. I'm clumsy. Never, ever. Anywho, moral of the story is everything in moderation. You can totally have that anime. It's part of it. It is a thing in anime. Just... Come on. Let's keep it... Like me, I can't eat 10 bags of Pop Rocks.
Well, you could. You're not going to feel good after that.
Yeah, true. Exactly. But one bag of Pop Rocks, sick. I haven't had Pop Rocks in a while, and I'm actually now kind of wanting some.
So anyways.
Okay, then.
Going back to my point, as a woman representing my sex, I enjoy seeing strong female leads that don't have to be overly sexual. Because if we have a daughter and she, if she wants to watch anime, listen, she's going to be watching Inuyasha when she's 4 or so years old. She's going to be indoctrinated at some point.
Which, this weekend, trailer for the new show.
Oh my gosh, guys. I can't wait. I haven't finished Inuyasha yet. I'm in the final act.
Yes.
So I have, how many did I watch? Maybe 3 episodes. Yes. So I got like 21 left.
Which, production value through the roof.
Holy crap.
Our one gripe instantly, though, the change of voice actors. They're good. They're close.
Listen, I don't care. Change Kagome's voice. It doesn't matter. Dude, you screwed me over with changing Shoshomaru's voice. I can't handle it.
Dismantle the show, but not my Shoshomaru. Even Jochen's pissed, I'm sure. He's like, whoa, who is this?
But yes, I'm just happy for some strong female leads because we need women. Granted, they're just pencil drawings on paper that have been animated. There's not enough. Sure, Black Widow, she's cool. Wonder Woman, she's cool. But I need more like my level.
But that's just it, though. It's in the last couple of years, it's ramping up. And are we going to act like we haven't seen all the characters in Mass Effect? We've got
Miranda, who is very sexual, and everyone else. The only one who's not is if you play female Shepard, okay?
Wait, this is like an awakening moment. Because I was just also going to say Lara Croft. The new Lara Croft with actual proper proportions. Super cool character. Yeah, PS1 Lara Croft with those triangles coming out of her torso. Maybe you're right, a little over-sexualized, yeah. But we're making our way downtown, walking fast. We are progressing, clearly seen in these two shows, some really cool characters, especially Lizard Girl.
Anak. Yes, there you go.
There's your name. Welcome.
She's very cool.
And the weapons in that show...
Yeah, the episode we ended on yesterday, we're learning more about the lore of the swords that Bam ends up getting. You'll find out when you watch the show. He can control it, and it's sick when it happens in, like, episode one that happens,
that
right?
Yeah, that was really cool.
It was so cool. I was like, this is sick.
The weapons in this show, like, well, at least these highest tier weapons, they have these entities in them. So when he is asking this, it's episode one. I'm going to spoil at least this for you in Tower of God. He's basically asking this sword for help.
Give him strength.
And this is where it's almost reverse. It's like the reverse Roshi. The sword is this woman who comes out and she's willing to help. And then this other character is like, well, she never wants to help me. She goes, well, I don't want to help women. I want to help cute boys.
Yeah, it was so cute. Yeah.
So that was pretty funny.
She ends up coming to his rescue in a couple. The being in the sword. It's so cool when that happens. It's like, oh, I want that to happen more because that is goosebumps when that happens.
Absolutely. And this is another great thing. I'm going to keep repeating it, I guess. This is another one. No excuses, any of you. I'm looking right at you through sound waves. Take that how you will. They're 13 episodes apiece. Even if you just watch 20 minutes a night and you're super busy, which proud of you because you're clearly out there crushing it if you're that busy. But if you're that busy, it's only going to take you 2 weeks to watch these shows. That's not asking much. I don't know why I have to even bargain with you. Just watch them. Do yourself the favor. We've been talking. If you are sad, there's an anime for that. If you're down and you're really just unmotivated, there is an anime for that, especially the two that were giving you right now.
Or if you're happy and you want to be more hyped, there's an anime for that. Mm-hmm. And it's these two.
It's
especially God of High School, because I can't, my brain, I told Tom when we finished that last episode, I said, I need a slice of life when we're done with these, because I can't handle, I think I need a break from the hype and the shonen.
Yeah.
I need something real.
Some
but then
more
when I watch
slices,
but then when I watch Slice of Life, I get not depressed, but it makes my heart hurt because they're always about a love story and it gives me a stomach ache because I'm back to those like feeling like a tween.
Yeah. The great thing with the Slice of Life, though, is brings you back to those times you remember and the things that you messed up. You know, me, teenage boy, I couldn't even talk to anyone. And then you watch and you'll see another awkward character and then they handle it well. And you're like, man, wish that could have been me, but I'm glad he did it. Or just anything like that. We even found out this is starting to spin out of control to other stuff. Speaking of slice of life, if that's in fact what it's going to be, we were talking about how outrageous, how you can make an anime out of anything. We did see on Twitter there is going to be an anime based around pottery. And you guys don't know it, but Danielle here used to throw some pottery.
Mm-hmm.
So actually might be an interesting one. I think we should check that one out at some point.
Yeah, it was a manga, and now they're going to make it into a show. I didn't look at the Crunchyroll article too in-depth yet. I kind of did a brief skim, but don't know what that's going to be about, but hopefully it's interesting. I'm willing to give it a go.
Absolutely. And we were talking with Michael, what up, Michael, about another concept, and I'm putting this on the books here right now in front of all of you guys so that if someone does end up making this concept after the air date of this, they're in trouble because it was me. We were out disc golfing today, and there's some sports anime that I want to watch some. We haven't really seen any. We missed that wave.
That was last year was a sports
anime. But we're going to go back to that wave at some point just to check it out because they even have one at badminton. Let's go. I like some badminton. But I was thinking as we're out there disc golfing, there's so much cool shit that you can do with that weird, quirky sport and anime. We already started actually shotgunning a couple concepts, and frankly, I might.
You start a webtoon.
That's just it. I'm going to do what these absolute legends did. Release a webcomic. Yeah, it might take 10 years, but maybe Crunchyroll will knock on the door and be like, hey, it's time.
Come along down this wonderful journey called anime.
Man. But those, you've heard us say it. I'm going to say it another time. Go watch these. Hopefully you enjoy it as much as we have. We're going to start slowly putting in more gripes. I'm glad that we actually had some negatives. I feel like we're a little bit too positive with a lot of shows. And so you guys might go out and watch a show and be like, okay, well, they didn't tell me that this part sucked. There's going to be some sucky parts. Power through. Well, not in these shows. These ones are good.
Concise. Okay, I'm looking at you sucky parts. I have loved every minute so far.
Yeah. Talking in general, these 13 episodes, they don't have time for sucky parts.
Well, we haven't finished Tower of God, so we can't guarantee that there might not be something hidden there. But so far, 6 episodes in out of 13, we're Gucci.
We're going to give you the 6-episode manufacturer's guarantee. Anything after that, that's on.
That's on you.
Yeah, no returns. Sorry. So thanks for joining us once again. We hope you have a great week ahead, and make sure to check us out on Instagram. We're really putting a push on there, and we are having some progress. A lot of followers. Thank you, everyone who has followed. And at the point of this airing, we'll have the post already, but we are doing a giveaway for hitting at least the 100 milestone. But now, at this point, we're going to be at 200 here shortly.
It ramped up really quick. I couldn't believe it.
So if you're followed, make sure to look out for that and enter for that. If you haven't followed, go do that for the chance to just win. In general, how many opportunities in life do you have to win things? You're not going to win the lottery. Well, one of you might, but no one else will. You're not going to win that nonstick pan set from Bed Bath & Beyond. Just try and win this prize that we're putting up.
Yeah. And if you have a My Anime list, or if you don't have one, you should make one. It's a nice way to keep track of all the anime you've watched and get depressed with how many days you've actually spent in your life watching.
Yes, myanimelist.com. Actually, you get to put in what you've watched, what you're in the progress. You can create this list in all these different things. You rate it. You can put you're on hold. You're watching it. You finished it. And if you've finished the episodes, because it'll have like what episode are you on, yada, yada, unless, of course, you put finished on. Okay, stop, Tom. All right, you got it. So you then get, because it's equating how many episodes per minute, it'll give you a timer of all of the anime you've watched, how much of your life has gone into watching anime. We only put in 2 or 3 shows, and it showed 3 straight days of anime, and I was actually a little shocked.
And I added a shit ton of shows, I'm really going to look forward. But anyways, if you have one, look for us. I Married a Weeb is on there. You can follow us, see what we're watching.
And we'll put our link to it on our website as well. Just give it to Google. It's still a Podbean site, but we're going to eventually have an actual I Married a Weeb site. So thank you again. We appreciate you. You know what time it is. I'm done, Danielle. You're done. Not because I'm telling you, just because I can tell that you are. Now, can you do me a solid? Will you do me that favor? Will you please tell these people goodbye?
Bye, guys.